first time, feel welcome. This is where we are. And this is where God blesses us. Amen?
Amen.
Our dear brother Tony is not with us today. He's away. And he sent his greetings. How many have received? Oh, some have not received. Some are not in. Okay. I see. Amen?
Amen?
Yes, our pastor just left a while ago. He was here. And he has gone to minister somewhere else. Pastor Washington, that is. I bless the name of the Lord this afternoon for such an opportunity to talk to us. And I'm happy. God bless you so much. That's what I'll talk about. And I want to bring to our attention that earlier our brother Joseph talked to us about the key. And I bet now everybody can key in. Is it true? Can everybody key in and get something worthwhile?
Yes.
Well, we are yet to see. Amen? Yes, I give God praise for this. Yes, I want to talk about principled focus. There are, first of all, if I can give a definition, principles are guidelines towards what is expected of somebody. A principled person, for example, can be somebody who is determined to a will. And when he looks at what he wants to do, he does it with audacity and pomp. Focus is your goal. So a principled focus is a determination to reach somewhere, but with proper guidelines. Proper guidelines. Now that you have been given the key that you have been given, how will you use it? Do you know the principles of the key? The principles of the key is to open. So everything on this earth has got principles. Everything. The principle of leadership says everything rises or falls with leadership. Anybody who is on the throne can make the people or break the people. Everything relies on him. If he's the king, what he says carries the day. So if he is principled, then whatever he looks at and whatever he decides, that will be according to his principle. Amen?
Amen?
According to his decision, what he has decided. I want to give you a flashback in the history of Kenya. And it is a political example. There was a time when a former president, Kibaki, was in power. And then the opposition had a name by the name Pentagon. And they used to disturb the president so much. Yeah, a lot. In fact, the president was so disturbed that the people around the dead president, Kibaki, decided to tell him, stand by your principles, whatever you say shall carry the day. So the Pentagon thought that he would never make a decision of throwing them out. But he did. He did. He just said, okay, Pentagon, you are dismissed from this government. You can go away. Even though the government hung at two legs of a chair, the then president stood with it to the end. Why? Because he was principled. He stood by his words. So to be principled, on the other hand, is to stand by your guns, to declare what you want done, and to agree within yourself that this is it and this is final. There is somebody in the Bible who had so many things to do, and he never prioritized, and he failed. His name is King Solomon. I want to make a checklist of some decisions that he made and some things that he did that made him flop. Why? Because he was not principled. He did all things. And of the things that he didn't pair in and say, this is what I want. There is a famous man of God by the name James Maxwell. Maxwell once said that there's a principle that he brought so that people can prioritize what they are doing. Like, for example, I have so many things in life that I want to do. So Maxwell said, write them down, 1 to 10 points that you want to do. After writing them, look at what you need more first, put it on top. And what you need the least, put it at the bottom. Then check what you want to do first. Do that first. That is ability to be principled in what you have outlined to do. And then when you write them down, your focus will not dwindle or get away, but you will always be focused. How many preachers have you seen? They can preach about something, and at the end of it, end the other way around. Which means that the topic that he gave, he never ended with it. It means that he was unprincipled or in principle. So I want to say this. For the principle focus, for you to be focused, you must note down what you are prioritizing. Then, after noting down, you take one after the other. One after the other. I know of King Solomon when he was in power. Allow me to read from the book of Ecclesiastes, chapter 2. He learned it the hard way. And when he was doing all these things, he did them collectively without prioritizing. And when he did them collectively, he did everything by himself. I shall read chapter 2 from verse 1. The Bible says, I said in my heart, come now, I will test you with mirth. Therefore, enjoy pleasure. But surely this also was vanity. I say to Laughter, madness, and of mirth, what does it accomplish? I searched in my heart how to gratify my flesh with wine, while guiding my heart with wisdom, and how to lay hold on folly, till I might see what was good for the sons of men to do under heaven all the days of their lives. Verse 4. I made my works great. I built myself houses. I planted myself vineyards. I made myself gardens and orchards. I planted all kinds of fruit trees in them. I made myself water pools from which to water the growing trees of the grove. I acquired male and female servants, and had servants born in my house. Yes, I had greater possessions of herds and flocks than all who were in Jerusalem before me. I also gathered for myself silver and gold, and the special treasures of kings and of the provinces. I acquired treasures of kings. I acquired male and female singers, and delights of the sons of men, and musical instruments of all kinds. You can imagine, this is Solomon. He acquired everything for himself. And he did them all, but in the long run, you know what he said? That all was vain. See, a certain singer sang somewhere. A singer. Is it a worshiper or a singer? A singer or a worshiper? A singer or a worshiper? Those are two different things. So, somebody once sang. Maybe ni reiterate kidogo tu ni kijana, si mzee kama mimi. Hayo yote ni vanity. Oh, ni vanity. Praise the name of the Lord. Yeah, he was quoting what King Solomon did. In fact, when he sang the song, he was saying, when he was being grilled somewhere on TV, on open air, he was asked, why did you sing this song? He said that everything that he had in life, he didn't see any good thing in it, because he didn't prioritize. He had no disciplined focus. So he missed the mark. To miss the mark is to sin. Praise the name of the Lord. Amen. Well, I want to tell us this, that anybody doing anything, if you are not principled, you'll be derailed. Well, I don't know whether our focus is to man or to God. The Bible says somewhere in, I think, Hebrews chapter 13, maybe verse 5, 6 or somewhere, it says something like, amelaniwa yeye amtegemea mwanadamu. That's something like that. So, when we say we depend on God, we should depend on God. And let our attributes be in line with God. When we are not disciplined and we are not principled towards the discipline that we have brought forth, then we lose the focus. What is focus? Focus is your goal. Very many people, when they woke up today, they say, I will be in church. Maybe that was the primary focus. But now the deeper focus was, when I am there, I know that I will be blessed. Where does that blessing come from? The blessing comes from the word of God. So the word being the key that you have been given, in the discipline that you have, if at all you don't have that discipline to that focus that you had, that goal, then immediately you fall asleep and don't get anything that you are being given. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
So I want to tell us this day, Solomon lacked consistency. He pursued too many things in too short a time. He pursued so many things. So today I want to tell us, if you want to have a principled focus, prioritize, write down and single out and know what you want. Yeah, you must know what you want. Well, Solomon also pursued the wrong goals. Well, I don't know whether our coming to church is to please ourselves or God. Well, we may all come to church. There may be something that fascinates you more than the other. Amen?
Amen.
Well, today, maybe you have not prioritized what you have, but now here I am saying, if at all my priority was because of somebody and I haven't seen him, I become crestfallen. That's one. If at all it was an activity that was to be undertaken and it flopped, the priority somehow about to reach but didn't reach, almost, I'm saying something. Yeah, so I'm here saying this. A disciplined focus, it matters a lot what you focus on. That which you focus on, does it build? In the least, according to the Pareto principle of John Maxwell, of the least, have you started from the bottom, which is the least? Then you end with the most you wanted, or the most you wanted to the least you wanted. Now this is where you can either gather or not gather. Yeah, you either gather or not. Why? Because of the primary focus. That primary focus is very, should be very principled in itself. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Amen. So I want to tell us this. Sometimes we have self-serving goals. Maybe if I would ask somebody, why are you today in church? Somebody will tell me, I just came. Somebody will tell me, you know, it was so boring in the house. I had just come. I'm broke, you know, something. Or I wanted to meet so-and-so so that we go out after church. People have got very many reasons why they come to church. Well, somebody will even be ashamed not to tell you why. Maybe somebody you really need to see. So when you just sit down on yourself, so I'm all right. Amen. Yeah, very many people lack control in what their focus is. Although I will say that there is a danger in too many pursuits. If you are in church, in fact, I have a remedy for all this. If King Solomon knew God better, he wouldn't have married the many wives. He wouldn't have indulged in too much pleasure. He wouldn't have planted vineyards and planted trees and had so many things, which in the long run he left, because in the long run somewhere, he muttered in chapter 12 of the very book, Ecclesiastes chapter 12, there's some regrets that he gave. Ecclesiastes chapter 12, regrets come. So, verse 1, he says, remember now your creator in the days of your youth, before the difficult days come, and the years draw near, when you say, I have no pleasure in them. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Sometimes, when we miss the mark and lose the focus, and don't dwell in the discipline that we have, doctrines may be good, we follow them. But when the Spirit of God is missing, then that principled focus is dimmed and you are no more. Why? Because all that you attributed to what, you never achieved. So, you decide. But it is always good to stand firm in the Lord that you know. That's why Paul reached somewhere and said, in him that I believe, I have confidence. Philippians 4:13. Yeah. In him that I know, I have confidence. I'm saying it the other way around, because that's how it came. Praise the name of the Lord.
Yeah.
Yes. So we who are of the Lord, there are the principles of the Lord which we also ought to be in. Like now, let's say for example, now you have a desire. And that desire is like a vacuum. It's like a gap. It wants to be filled. The only person who can fill it is Jesus. And that is why we are here as an entity towards one focus. The Bible says somewhere in Romans chapter 8, Romans chapter 8, verse 26, it says, likewise the Spirit also helps in our weaknesses, for we do not know what we should pray for as we ought, but the Spirit himself makes intercession for us with groanings which cannot be uttered. Maybe when you came here in the morning, found people praying, and now because you found people praying, you pray. But you just pray without a goal. I want to tell us, everybody that has been called of God, we must pray with a designated goal within. That goal must be present. That goal must be very present, so that it doesn't derail the focus of what you want to achieve. The achievement that you want to achieve must be based on God. When it's not based in God, then the principal focus vanishes. It vanishes. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
The Bible says in verse 27 that now he who searches the hearts knows what the mind of the Spirit is. Who is this? The Spirit of God. When we allow ourselves to remain on God and to depend on him, so he can give us, or he can direct the discernment within us to go in line with what God is illuminating, so that you can know from the Spirit of God what the Lord is speaking to your life right now. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
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 I will repeat that verse 27. Now he who searches the hearts knows what the mind of the Spirit is, because he makes intercession for the saints according to the will of God. When King Solomon had his protocol, or the rules that he had governing his nation as the king, he did all things. He did all things by himself, later regretted. When we don't rely in Jesus or on the Holy Spirit, then we end up standing alone. Why? Because prayer, you took it solely. You never relied on the Holy Spirit to give you. When directions were given, you took on yours. You never took the ones that you were given. When you came from home, you come into this place so that we can together navigate towards your goal, so that the Spirit can illuminate and help you. When we depend on God, the Spirit of discernment comes to jolt us so that we stand. And when we stand, we gather. According to who? According to the will of God. So it is by the will of God that you are here. And it is not by mistake that you are hearing what you are hearing. And what remains is for you not just to be a hearer, but a doer of what you hear. When you become a doer of the word, So you apply it to your life. So that you gather a standing, and then the Lord illuminates His Spirit to your will. Amen?
Amen.
So that you achieve the focus that you have. The focus that you have can never be achieved if you go it alone. The Spirit of God illuminates into you only if you incline yourself unto the Lord. How do you incline yourself unto the Lord? By being sensitive to every word that you hear and adhering to it, possessing each and every word that you hear, saying, this that He has spoken is mine. If it is the case, you take it. If it is the prioritization, you prioritize. If it is the focus, then you must have a disciplined focus so as to achieve. Achievement doesn't just come. No, it doesn't just come. At one time, I was given in so much reading of books. I read books. I've read books and read books until I reached a time when I told God, now I think I've read enough. Yeah, then I listened to what the Spirit could say. Spirit told me, now read the Bible. I took all the books that I had, and I put aside. I'm talking to somebody who is defeated of the things that you have done so singly on your own. You are unable. But now help has come in the name of the will of God for your life, which says, if you depend on the Lord, then He shall sustain you. The Bible says somewhere in Psalms chapter 55, verse 22, cast your cares upon the Lord, and He shall sustain you. He shall never let the righteous dwell in evil. Yeah, He shall never. In fact, when God looks at us, He looks at us as people who are great. But when we look at ourselves, we look at ourselves as people who are orphans without a father. Yeah, sometimes you know when you depend so much on yourself, and when you are defeated, you say, now how shall it be? Then you give up. Then it means that you've given up even on God. But when you depend on God, the Lord makes a turnaround, and He allows your spirit to be sharpened so that He can illuminate His Spirit into it. The Spirit of God doesn't force Himself into us, but we must yield. So the steps of salvation are one. We must declare that we believe in the Word. Then salvation comes in. Then steps of teachings must come in, so that we stand firm. And in the Word that we hear, we must heed. And then the problems that we have, we must focus to God and never look to the sides, so that the Lord can illuminate that which He purports for you to reach the focus which is your goal deep in your heart. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
So this day I want to tell us that the very many people who are focused and never let go, the Lord made them achieve. People like Moses, they sat in the temple of God. People like David, even though they flopped, they never relaxed there. They woke up again. They said, Lord, I'm sorry. And the Lord made them kings, made them greater than they thought. Look at Paul. Paul was there. And the many things that he did in the early times, he brought people of God down. He fell them down and made a spectacle of them and rubbished them off. But when time came, on his way to Damascus one day, he met the Lord Jesus and made a turnaround in his life. I'm talking to somebody who is defeated in his life, He said, how can it be to me also? There is room for them that have got a disciplined focus. Yes, a principled person the Lord can never leave out. When we are not principled by our wits and that which we think of ourselves, then we are the one who leave the Lord out. But the Lord says, I have sent my son to die for your sins so that you can be in the fold and stand firm in the faith of your calling. Praise the name of the Lord. Amen. So I want to tell us today, it doesn't matter what things you have undergone. It doesn't matter how emaciated you feel. The Lord is not done yet with you. He can still furnish you. Can still refurbish you. He can still make you again. He can still fabricate your life and make it better. The Bible says in Jeremiah, somewhere in chapter 18, verse 4, that a vessel that he was making got spoiled and marred in his hands, but he made it better again. It is only the Lord who can make us better, but only if our focus doesn't dwindle. The focus that you have for the Lord must be stationary. It must be stationary. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
So I want to tell us this day, the things that you have undergone, stash them away. It is us, when we are forgiven, that we can go again to the priorities that we had and pick from the bottom the things that you already left, the things that you already forgiven, the guilt that you already forgiven. You go again there and pick it. And you say, I think maybe the Lord never forgave me this. Then you pray with it again. Stop it. Rely on God. The things that He is giving you, the word that He is giving you to rely on Him, is the best. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
So I read books, I left them. And now I read the word of God. And it yields much. It yields much. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
When I wake up in the morning, I look at the word of God. I reflect to it. And I say, God, give me a verse that I can read for the morning. Then He tells me, go to Psalms chapter 5. I go there. I read verse 1 to 3. It gives me a kickstart for the morning. Why? Because I depend on Him. So now I don't depend on anything else, but I depend on God. How many of us are willing to depend on God? How many? Yes. When we depend on God, it is only the Lord that illuminates to us. But now it depends with how principled you are. Are you lifting your hand because so and so is lifted? Or you are to it? Yes, that is what it is. The focus shall be reached when the heart is in line with the Lord's. The will of the Lord is clear. He says that I have sent my son to die for you. Then I have sent saints to preach. I have sent the fivefold ministry so that you can be taught and get to know. In that knowledge, with time, we grow richly with grace. When we grow in the grace of the Lord, then the Lord illuminates what is the next step. And when we take that step, our lives will never be the same again. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Holiness comes because there's a deep desire within. When someone is sick and he goes to a chemist and says, over-the-counter drugs, oh, I feel headache, the doctor will only give you some painkillers. Why? Because you said you had some headache, so they just try to treat what you have said. Why am I trying to say this? I'm trying to look at somebody who is principled looking at God and saying, Lord, do a diagnosis of what I need so that you can come to the root cause of what I really need. You see, sometimes when we go to the chemist and he just says, this is the IFA stomachache. Where? Here. Which part? The lower part, the upper part, the center part? Then, if the doctor be a practitioner, a medical practitioner, that is, he can go as far as saying, okay, maybe try this or try this. You see, the word they try. It is the word they try. But when we depend on God, the Lord brings something that you ought to have. The Bible says in Romans chapter 8 that when we depend on God, He grants us. He grants us by His grace that which we ought to have. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
So this day I want to tell us, let us have some principles. If I am sick, let my blood be checked, my stool. That's when I'm sick. So that they can get the root cause of that sickness. So that I get total healing. But when I go over the counter, I'll just get a partial treatment. Let us not call it healing. It's a partial treatment. Which doesn't take the whole thing away, but it just kills the pain for a time, it will come back. So when we are not saved, when we acquire of God, we may not achieve much. Why? Because it's just like a story being told. Oh, I heard of Jesus. Oh, you heard of him? I heard of him. When you go to Jesus, because you don't have the keys to go about it in detail. So you just say, you know me, I need prayers. What can you pray for? Just pray for me, just pray for me. What can you pray for? Just pray for me, just pray for me. Maybe you are ashamed of what you want to be praying for. And you know, when we are not loyal before the Lord, then maybe the Lord may not answer our prayers. The Bible says that when we are plain before God, when we are right, when we say what it is, then the Lord will remove that which is a hindering block, a hindrance to our lives. Let us all rise. So I want to tell us this day that just as much as your focus has been dwindled, what matters is that you get back to God and tell the Lord, Lord, I need you. Lord, I need you in everything. Sharpen my focus so that I don't miss the mark. Let us be ahead within ourselves to aspire, not only to be hearers, but to be doers of the word. When we are in our cocoons at home, we can still be there and speak to the Lord as well. Maybe in the church we only have some few hours, but in your house you have all the time. Cry to God. There are some prayers that the Lord can hear. But now it depends with the adamance from within. It depends with how much agonizing you can agonize before God. Because I believe that God answers desperate prayers. Yes, the desperate prayers, those are the ones that the Lord can answer. How desperate is somebody? When you are desperate, you key in and you cry for the Lord. You tell the Lord, this is what I need. He gives you. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Yes, we shall sing. And then we shall go before the Lord and decree.
Baba wetu wa mbinguni, yanipasa nishukuru, nisingeli kuwa ni wewe, nisingeli pata wokovu, nisingeli kuwa ni wewe, nisingeli pata wokovu.
And Father, you shall govern our loins and dwell in our inner man, giving us the ability to stand firm in the faith, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Father, I thank you this day. Bless your people. Help us, Lord, to stand and to stand firm all the time. In the name of Jesus Christ, I pray for each and every one, oh Lord God, them that need you, them that, Lord, are downhearted. Father, lift them up. In the name of Jesus Christ. Them that feel lonely, O Lord God, lift them high, the name of Jesus Christ. Father, help them, O Lord God, to stand from them that are sickly. My Savior, I decree healing in their lives, the name of Jesus Christ. Them that are downhearted, O my Savior, lift them, O God. Be the Savior in their lives. I give you praise and honor because you are a good God. We bless you, Jesus, this day. Bless our pastor wherever he is, together with Brother Tony, Lord. Bless them, O dear God. Walk with them. Dwell in them, Lord God. We give you praise and honor because you are a good God. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
And may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Lamb of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen.
Thank you.